Brother Nuri just made the comparison between Imam Musa al-Kadhim alayhi salam and Mawla Hussain alayhi salam. It is interesting as poets how we make comparisons between the tragedies that befell the Ahlul Bayt and how different personalities endured this. You've heard about how Imam Musa al-Kadhim alayhi salam, who was known as the prisoner of Baghdad, met his fate, how his hands were shackled in chains, and how he used to try and peer out through the bars of the prison but was beaten every time he did. Now I just want you to take your mind to another prisoner. Take your minds to Sham and there's 2 4-year-old wrists that are clenched in chains, that are wrapped in chains. And every time she looks out of that window, she sees the doves flying home and she says to her aunt, "Oh aunt, when are we going to go home like these doves?" They say that Mawla Hussain's body was left without a shroud, but this 4-year-old girl's body was also left without a shroud. It is said when the Ahlul Bayt, when the ladies of the Ahlul Bayt were giving a ghusl, they screamed and they asked Mawla Sajjad, "Oh Imam, is this young girl ill for some reason?" Mawla said, "Why'd you say that?" They said, "All the skin on her body is a different color. Some of it's yellow, some of it's black, some of it's blue. Is she sick? Does she have fungus growing on her?" Mawla said, "Please don't say that. She's the pure daughter of a pure Imam. You see, Shimmer used to slap her so hard and beat her so hard that all of her skin changed color." Then they asked Mawla, "Mawla, whenever we try and take her clothes off to give her ghusl, we can't do that." Imam said that when we're in the bazaar of Sham, people used to throw things at us. There was a point when a woman stood on the balcony and to take her revenge on our grandfather, she poured boiling water over our caravan. And it so happened that this young girl was under the boiling water and it burned her skin in such a way that her clothes and her skin became one. And since then, it's been stuck together. The only thing I ask you is that we say that Mawla Hussain was lonely. We say Imam Musa al-Kadhim was lonely. But in reality, they are buried next to their loved ones. But think about that 4-year-old girl who's in Sham, whose voice you can still hear when you go to do her ziyarat. When she says that this prison is very dark, if you can, just light one candle before you leave. When the Ahlul Bayt returned to Karbala after Sham, it is said that Bibi Zainab, and this is a very strange circumstance, a strange situation. Bibi Zainab, when she came to the grave of her brother, she didn't come walking to the grave, she came crawling on her hands and knees. When you go crawling on your hands and knees to somewhere, it is when you're asking for forgiveness. She must have said to her brother, "Oh brother, on that day of Ashura, you left me with one amana, but I've left that amana in Sham. Please forgive me."
Bhai ja aap ko bheja hai, Sakina ne salam, apne ammu ke liye hai, ye bhatiji ka kala. Bujh gayi pyaas shikayat ka nahi koi kala, paani ke vaaste shay milda hai ammu kyun kar, maaf karna maaf karna, chhod kar aayi hoon zinda mein sakina ko, maaf karna mujhe maaf karna,
ur salo apni sakina ka, mere maa jaye
जिसको अरमान था उसको ही नहीं ला पाए। घर चलो कहती रही आखिरी दम तक हाय, उसको बहलाती रही जल्दी चलेंगे हम घर।
माफ करना मुझे, माफ करना।
कौन परदेश में है कब्र पे जाने वाला, कौन है शाम ढल शम मा जलाने वाला। कोई हम दर्द नहीं गम का बताने वाला, मेरे माँ जाए बहुत खाई है हमने ठोकर।
माफ करना मुझे, माफ करना।
नन्ही सी जान उठाई है जफाए क्या क्या, एक शराबी ने कनीजी नन्ही सी जान उठाई है जफाए क्या क्या, एक शराबी ने कनीजी के लिए जब मांगा, मेरा सजा है रत से लहू रो दिया था, बड़ी हसरत से हमें देख रही थी मुझते।
माफ करना मुझे, माफ करना।
In the courtyard